I'm Stuart Mason Dambrot. I'm the creator and host of Critical Thought TV. I'm a researcher and a consilientist and a futurist. What that means is that I'm interested in a wide range of topics. I look for the neocortical connection between disparate areas and then run out research trends into the near, mid, and long-term future. This is about events that I experienced when I was young, 7, 8 years old, and they came in rapid succession. The first was my wondering and asking adults, my parents and others, if I got into a rocket ship and traveled greater than the speed of light, could I land at my destination and see the ship arriving? I had not read anything by Einstein at that point in time, but it was, you know, an interesting question to me. And it turns out there is an answer. The next one was watching Mr. Wizard. And there was a circular disc with polygons, essentially, you know, curved on the outside, black and white. He was going to spin it, and he told the audience in on the set that they would see color, and he advised us, this being black and white television days, that we would not at home. But I did. And again, in that moment, I realized that this is something else behind the curtain, that I had to be perceiving that color in my brain. So this, a lot of these things happened. Those two were really the first two and the most seminal. There were issues about having discussions with geometry teachers in the third grade when they would talk about Euclidean geometry and 180 degrees always being the total of a triangle. And I said, what if it's on a curved surface? I didn't know from Riemannian geometry at the time. But again, so I was always looking beyond the obvious. I was just always drawn to not just what was happening, but why was it happening, and what does it mean for what's going to happen next? Since I look at technology, and talking about advancing technology, as the evolution of the ways in which we extend our sensory motor cortex into the environment, spears, carts, microscopes, telescopes, and lastly, the brain itself. This has all led to what I do. Because I love it so much, because I love learning so much, I have CriticalThought.tv, as I mentioned, which is a show where these things are discussed in the hopes of stimulating the same passion in others. That's it. Okay.